Okay, in this video, I'll show you guys how to figure out the trig function values at quadrantal angles. And because they are quadrantal angles, in fact, we cannot draw any reference triangles. Because quadrantal angles, their terminal sides will be on either the x-axis or the y-axis. Okay? And to deal with this, we actually have to use the concept of the unit circle. And let me show you. First of all, let's look at sine of 180 degrees. I will draw the picture right here, of course. And as always, start with the positive x-axis like this. This time, we have to rotate counterclockwise 180 degrees. So it's going to be like this, right? And the terminal side is just like that. You see, we cannot draw any reference triangle. In this kind of situation, we are just going to put down the unit circle like this. And now this looks like a poker ball, it's not. Anyway, here is the deal. This is a unit circle, so that means r is equal to 1, okay? And our focus is this point right here, because we are talking about 180 degrees. That's a terminal side, and that intercepts with the unit circle right here, okay? First of all, because r is equal to 1, from here, we go to the left one time, so the x value of this point is negative 1. And because we are on the x-axis, the y value is 0. So x is negative 1, y is equal to 0. Now when you have the x, y, and r value, you can figure out the sine value of this angle right here. So here we go. Sine of 180 degrees. Recall that sine is equal to y over r, right? Sine is equal to y over r. Okay, y is 0, r is 1. So in the end, of course, 0 over 1 is just 0, and then we are done. Sine of 180 degrees is 0. Now, let's look at cosine of 0. And by the way, do I mean this right here to be degrees or in radians? Well, doesn't matter. 0 degrees is the same as 0 radians. So we're all good. Anyway, draw the picture. Starting from the positive x-axis, and guess what? We don't have to turn because you don't turn anything 0 degrees or 0 radians, right? I cannot draw any reference triangle though. It's all good. You know r is equal to 1 and put down the unit circle right here. And the focus is at this point now. So from here to here is 1, so that's the x value. And we don't go up, right? So the y value is 0, x is 1, y is 0. Now, cosine of 0. Remember, cosine is equal to x over r. X is equal to 1. R is equal to 1 as well. 1 over 1 is still 1, and then we are done like that. Finally, tangent of 3 pi over 2. And when you see the pi, you know, people usually mean that we are talking about radians. Okay? So, if you like, you can just look at 3 pi over 2 and multiply this by 180 degrees over pi. So we can convert this into degrees. Pi, pi cancel. And now, reduce this real quick. 2 goes into 2 one time, 2 goes into 180, 90 times. 3 times 90 is 270, and that's in degrees, like that. Here's the picture. Okay, start from the positive x-axis. Rotate, this is 90, this is 180. Down below here, this is 270, right? So like that. And now put down the unit circle because we don't have the reference triangle. So put down the unit circle like this. And this is the point of our focus. Remember, r is equal to 1. Here, we are on the y-axis, so the x value is 0, and y will be negative 1 because things is down below, right? So negative 1. Here's the x, here's the y. Now, let's do tangent. Tangent of 3 pi over 2. And recall that tangent is equal to what over what? It's y over x, okay? Tangent is y over x. In this case, y is negative 1. X is equal to 0. So we have negative 1 over 0. And now, what's the response for this? Undefined, we cannot do this. This right here, we don't have an answer for it. The response for this is undefined. tangent of 3 pi over 2 is undefined.